The recent Atlanta spa shooting case highlighted the increased crimes involving Asian Americans. But interestingly, the leftist and the corporate media sometimes aggressively characterize the case as racially motivated. But sometimes they deliberately refuse to talk about the perpetrators and their motive. Why is that? Because there are convenient and inconvenient factors depending on the situation. In the Atlanta shooting rampage, the gunman is white. The 6 of the 8 victims died are Asian, so it is convenient to call it anti-Asian hate crime. Back in January in San Francisco, an 84-year-old Asian man was pushed to the ground by a 19-year-old man and died in broad daylight. The perpetrator is an African-American man. The left-leaning district attorney of San Francisco, Chesa Boudin, was quoted by New York Times saying that this young man was just some sort of temper tantrum. So in this case, it is inconvenient to call it anti-Asian crime. To get more perspectives about this phenomenon, I interviewed Kenny Xu, a young Asian-American journalist from Washington, D.C. area. He is the author of the upcoming book, An Inconvenient Minority, the Ivy League Admissions Cases and the Attack on Asian American Excellence. So Kenny, most of the news media and the left-leaning officials and organizations characterized the Atlantic shooting rampage as hate crime against Asian American community. How do you see it?
So first of all, we should condemn the attacks unequivocally. I mean, there is no excuse to kill innocent people. There is no excuse whatsoever. However, I'm concerned about how this discourse is going with regards to these attacks, because the immediate reaction is to blame it on white supremacy. First of all, the guy who killed the Asian Americans, the motive is still unclear. Second of all, Asian Americans were killed. And by the way, the rates of attacks on Asian Americans has increased 150% over the past year. But Asian Americans have been killed, you know, based on 2018 data. 25% of the perpetrators are white. 27% of the perpetrators are black. So it's not just a white supremacy thing. Asian people are being, you know, killed and harmed from people of all different races. And to paint it as a one-sided narrative, I think, is very damaging.
So in the Atlantic case, the media was very quick to reveal that the suspect is a white and characterized the case as a white supremacy. But on the other hand, in many cases where Asian Americans attacked, in, for example, San Francisco, Oakland, and New York, sometimes the news media avoid to talk about the race, ethnicity of the suspects, especially if they are certain race.
Well, the media has often been very unfaithful in covering these kinds of attacks. I mean, they tried, I read about the attacks in Oakland and in San Francisco and New York City, and they tried so hard to conceal the names and the races of the perpetrators, whereas the Washington Post today comes out with this full profile of, you know, the attacker and perpetrator and what color and how he relates to white supremacy and everything like that. You know, so there is clearly a narrative that they are trying to advance here. They're trying to lump Asians back into a victim category to help to say to us, oh, we need to oppose white supremacy now. I mean, that's the purpose of it. But the reality is not that way at all. The facts don't match up with that at all. We have to look at the facts. We have to look at what's going on in our country realistically.
And in, you know, one of the cases in San Francisco, as I mentioned, an elderly Asian American man was just pushed to the ground and died. But the district attorney was quoted by New York Times calling the perpetrator an African American young man, his action as some sort of temper tantrum. So how do you think of this district attorney's comments?
Well, yeah, I mean, you have to condemn evil. Anybody who kills a person, you can't just say, oh, they're bad-tempered, you know? They're genuinely evil people out there, and you need to condemn that violence. What I would encourage your audience to do is separate fact from narrative, do your research, investigate. But don't make this a racial narrative. Don't make this a racial thing. There are racists from every color against every other color. You know, there's evil in this country. There's evil in this world. We know this, you know, and, you know, I believe that there is ultimate forgiveness and I believe that there is ultimate justice. But, and we should seek individual justice, but we should not try to clamor to make this a racial narrative as the left is trying to do.
Mm-hmm. And theoretically, Asian Americans should be considered as a minority group, just as other groups like African American or the Hispanic Americans. But the media and some people don't always treat them the same way. So how do you understand that?
Asian Americans, we inconvenience the left's narrative on race, because the left's narrative on race is this, and everybody knows this. If you are white, you are white supremacist, you're privileged, many kind of bad, you know, those kinds of things. If you're a person of color, you're a victim, and you're a victim of white supremacy. But what do they do with Asian Americans? Because Asian Americans are people of color, but if you look at the statistics today, Asian Americans have median incomes that are higher than whites. They have educational statistics that are higher than whites. How can that be if the narrative is about racism, if racism is oppressive? There's an element there that the left does not know how to address because they don't know how to talk about culture. And so they choose to suppress us. They choose to suppress us from admissions. They choose to suppress us from the discourse. They choose to suppress us from the racial narrative. And that is what my book is trying to expose.
So that probably explains why NBC News pondered whether violence against Asians should really be considered a hate crime, given that Asians are privileged and it might hamper the fight against systemic racism. Thank you for watching. I'm Cathy Zhang with the Sound of Hope News, and see you next time.